As temperatures drop and winter grips the country, the less fortunate in South Africa are preparing for the harsh realities that this season brings. Africa Muslims agencies on the ground distributing blankets, clothing and other essentials to thousands across the country. Sponsor a winter warmth pack for 280 rand to provide blankets, winter clothing and candles to families in need. Donate via Africa Muslims Agency and help us to spread warmth this winter. Africa Muslims Agency, commemorating 35 years of empowering, educating, inspiring.
وَضَرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلًا أَصْحَابَ الْقَرْيَةِ إِذْ جَاءَهَا الْمُرْسَلُونَ إِذْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهِمُ اثْنَيْنِ فَكَذَّبُوهُمَا فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِثٍ فَقَالُوا إِنَّا إِلَيْكُمْ مُرْسَلُونَ قَالُوا مَا أَنْتُمْ إِلَّا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُنَا وما أنزل الرحمن من شيء إن أنتم إلا تكذبون قالوا ربنا يعلم إنا إليكم لمرسلون وما علينا إلا البلاغ المبين قالوا إنا تطيرنا بكم لئن لم تنتهوا لنرجمنكم وليمسنكم منا عذاب أليم قالوا طائركم معكم أئن ذكرتم بل أنتم قوم مسرفون وجاء من أقصى المدينة رجل يسعى قال يا قوم اتبعوا المرسلين اتبعوا من لا يسألكم أجرا وهم مهتدون وما لي لا أعبد الذي فطرني وإليه ترجعون أأتخذ من دوني آلهة إن يردني الرحمن بضر لا تغني عني شفاعتهم شيئا ولا ينقذون إني إذا لفي ضلال مبين إني آمنت بربكم فاسمعون قيل ادخل الجنة قال يا ليت قومي يعلمون بما غفر لي ربي واجعلني من المكرمين وما أنزلنا على قومه من بعده من جند من السماء وما كنا منزلين إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم خامدون يا حسرة على العباد ما يأتيهم من رسول إلا كانوا به يستهزئون ألم يروا كم أهلكنا قبلهم من القرون أنهم إليهم لا يرجعون وإن كل لما جميع لدينا محضرون وآية لهم الأرض الميتة أحييناها وأخرجنا منها حبا فمنه يأكلون وجعلنا فيها جنات من نخيل وأعناب وفجرنا فيها من العيون ليأكلوا من ثمره وما عملته أيديهم أفلا يشكرون سبحان الذي خلق الأزواج كلها مما تنبت الأرض ومن أنفسهم ومما لا يعلمون وآية لهم الليل نسلخ منه النهار فإذا هم مظلمون والشمس تجري لمستقر لها ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم والقمر قدرناه منازل حتى عاد كالعرجون القديم لا الشمس ينبغي لها أن تدرك القمر ولا الليل سابق النهار وكل في فلك يسبحون وآية لهم أنا حملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون وخلقنا لهم من مثله ما يركبون وإن نشأ نغرقهم فلا صريخ لهم ولا هم ينقذون إلا رحمة منا ومتاعا إلى حين وإذا قيل لهم اتقوا ما بين أيديكم وما خلفكم لعلكم ترحمون وما تأتيهم من آية من آيات ربهم إلا كانوا عنها معرضين وإذا قيل لهم أنفقوا مما رزقكم الله قال الذين كفروا للذين آمنوا أنطعم من لو يشاء الله أطعمه إن أنتم إلا في ضلال مبين ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين ما ينذرون إلا صيحة واحدة تأخذهم وهم يخصمون فلا يستطيعون توصية ولا إلى أهلهم يرجعون ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم ينسلون قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا هذا ما وعد الرحمن وصدق المرسلون إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم جميع لدينا محضرون فاليوم لا تظلم نفس شيئا ولا تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون إن أصحاب الجنة اليوم في شغل فاكهون هم وأزواجهم في ظلال على الأرائك متكئون لهم فيها فاكهة ولهم ما يدعون سلام قولا من رب رحيم سلام قولا من رب رحيم سلام قولا من رب رحيم وامتازوا اليوم أيها المجرمون ألم أعهد إليكم يا بني آدم ألا تعبدوا الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين وأن اعبدوني هذا صراط مستقيم ولقد أضل منكم جبلا كثيرا أفلم تكونوا تعقلون هذه جهنم التي كنتم توعدون اصلوها اليوم بما كنتم تكفرون اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون ومن نعمر ننكسه في الخلق أفلا يعقلون وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين لينذر من كان حيا ويحق القول على الكافرين أولم يروا أنا خلقنا لهم مما عملت أيدينا أنعاما فهم لها مالكون وذللناها لهم فمنها ركوبهم ومنها يأكلون ولهم فيها منافع ومشارب أفلا يشكرون واتخذوا من دون الله آلهة لعلهم ينصرون لا يستطيعون نصرهم وهم لهم جند محضرون فلا يحزنك قولهم إنا نعلم ما يسرون وما يعلنون أولم يرى الإنسان أنا خلقناه من نطفة فإذا هو خصيم مبين وضرب لنا مثلا ونسي خلقه قال من يحيي العظام وهي رميم قل يحيي الذي أنشأها أول مرة وهو بكل خلق عليم الذي جعل لكم من الشجر الأخضر نارا فإذا أنتم منه توقدون أوليس الذي خلق السماوات والأرض بقادر على أن يخلق مثلهم بلى وهو الخلاق العليم إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا وهو العزيز الغفور الذي خلق سبع سماوات طباقا ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت فارجع البصر هل ترى من فتور ثم ارجع البصر كرتين ينقلب إليك البصر خاسئا وهو حسير ولقد زينا السماء الدنيا بمصابيح وجعلناها رجوما للشياطين وأعتدنا لهم عذاب السعير وللذين كفروا بربهم عذاب جهنم وبئس المصير إذا ألقوا فيها سمعوا لها شهيقا وهي تفور تكاد تميز من الغيظ كلما ألقي فيها فوج سألهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم نذير قالوا بلى قد جاءنا نذير فكذبنا وقلنا ما نزل الله من شيء إن أنتم إلا في ضلال كبير وقالوا لو كنا نسمع أو نعقل ما كنا في أصحاب السعير فاعترفوا بذنبهم فسحقا لأصحاب السعير إن الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير وأسروا قولكم أو اجهروا به إنه عليم بذات الصدور ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه وإليه النشور أأمنتم من في السماء أن يخسف بكم الأرض فإذا هي تمور أم أمنتم من في السماء أن يرسل عليكم حاصبا فستعلمون كيف نذير ولقد كذب الذين من قبلهم فكيف كان نكير أولم يروا إلى الطير فوقهم صافات ويقبل ما يمسكهن إلا الرحمن إنه بكل شيء بصير صدق الله العظيم.
صدق الله مولانا العظيم. Verily Almighty Allah speaks the truth. Jazakallah khair. Shukran to soon to be Hafiz Zuhair Hanika, who is a student of Sheikh Ismail Lund, for that beautiful recitation of the glorious Quran. May Almighty Allah accept And may Allah bless us all continuously through the barakah of the glorious Quran. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. My dearly beloved Jamaatul Muslimin, respected elders, mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters, and beautiful children, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Jummah Mubarak to each and everyone, and may Allah bless us on this auspicious day of Jummah. Ameen. Also to all our viewers on YouTube and Facebook, we extend to you a warm welcome to the proceedings of the Jummah today. And it gives me great pleasure to present to you our speaker for today, who really is no stranger to our community, mashallah, and that is the Honorable Hafiz Qari Sheikh Ismail Lond, who is currently the Imam at the Owal Masjid in Bukab, and also the head of Quranic Department Affairs at the MJC. Fadilata Sheikh Ismail Lond is here today to speak to us on a very beautiful and interesting topic, and that is dietary sources or dietary choices have spiritual effects. And without further ado, I call upon my honorable brother, friend, my cousin, mashallah, Fadilata Sheikh Ismail Lond, to kindly address us. Falitafaddal mashkura, ya Fadilata Sheikh.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اتبع هداه. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ni'mah of iman, for blessing us in making us of the ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the ummah of the Holy Quran. And we thank him Jalla Jalalu for all his favors, those that we are aware of and those that we may be unaware of. And we thank him subhanahu wa ta'ala for this opportunity to meet here in this beautiful precinct for this important activity, the weekly Jumu'ah, in response to his command in the Holy Quran, where he says, after أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. Oh, those who have believed, when the call is made to pray on a Friday, then hasten towards the remembrance of Allah and leave all worldly transactions. That is better for you if only you knew. So alhamdulillah, the instruction was given, the understanding was acquired, the intention was made, and Allah enabled us to act on the intention in response to his command. Alhamdulillah, may Allah illuminate our hearts and bless our minds, grant us understanding, and accept from us. Ameen. In the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses all that we need to make a success of this existence and to acquire success in the year after. That we believe. We believe it is for all times and all places, for all people and for all situations, that we believe. It is a book of belief, it is a book of law, a book of detailed narrative, and a book of general instruction. And amongst the general instruction that we find in the Holy Quran, that was embodied in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is guidance regarding how we take charge of our own development, our own preservation, and how we take responsibility for ourselves. Allah says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O those who have iman, alaykum anfusakum, it is upon you to take charge of yourselves. It is upon you to take responsibility for yourselves. عليكم أنفسكم. It is upon you to take care of yourselves. لا يضركم من ضل إذا اهتديتم. Those who have gone astray cannot harm you or will not harm you if you remain on guidance. Those who have gone astray with all that they claim to have and know and do, they cannot harm you or will not harm you if you remain on guidance. And no matter what they have done or plan to do or are doing, and no matter what you choose to do, in the end, إلى الله مرجعكم جميعا. To Allah is your return, all of you. فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. Then he will surely inform you of all that you used to do. The topic is unique because we find ourselves in a situation where we have access to everything and anything at the press of a button. And life is all about choices. But the amount of choices that we have today, the amount of choices and the variety of choices have increased exponentially. So many to choose from, we are confused. Menus have extended. That's the physical menus and the online menus. And then the variety of options where outlets are concerned, where we are going to spend and what we are going to consume. And at the end of the day, even though life is all about choices, it has become more difficult for us to make wiser choices. And no matter who we are, no matter what we do, every choice has a consequence. Every choice has either a positive consequence or a negative consequence. But every single thing we choose to do and actually end up doing has a consequence. So the topic is, dietary choices have spiritual effects or spiritual consequences. My physical body and my spiritual self. My physical self and my soul. Is there a connection? What does our deen tell us? And there are certain things we already know. Our deen tells us, if we do and we engage in something negative, a sin, a black dot appears on our hearts. Now you engage with any cardiologist and ask him if when dealing with the physical heart, he or she came across any hearts that are polka dotted, that have dots, they will tell you no. It's a spiritual blotch, a spiritual darkness, a spiritual dot. I do something physically negative, it affects me spiritually. The ablution, wudu, if you think about it, washing the face, washing the arms, wiping the head, washing the feet, a spiritual action, rather a physical action for an improved spiritual state. Physical action for an improved spiritual state. Bodies are laid to rest in the maqbara, physical body. But we believe the souls are in the barzakh. A different dimension, the next dimension. But when we go to the space where the physical bodies are laid to rest, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us to greet Assalamu alaikum ahl al-diyari min al-mu'mineen. Peace be upon you, O the inhabitants of the believing inhabitants of this dwelling. Physical body there, soul is in the barzakh, but we greet here. There's a connection. So likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where our consumption is concerned, gives us guidance. And there's one more that we know. We know Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam discouraged, and the Quran obviously clearly discouraged from the consumption of haram. That we know. He said there may be individuals, ash'atha aghbar, who look disheveled, who look dusty, who look worthy of a divine response. They look worthy of divine responses. They are raising their hands in plea to Allah. But their clothing is haram. Their acquisitions are all haram. وَغُذِيَ بِالْحَرَامِ. They have been nourished with haram. أَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. How can they be responded to by Allah? That's where haram is concerned. But I would love to address, in relation to our topic, 2 points. Quantity and quality. How much we consume and what exactly are we consuming, and can the amounts that we consume and the type of foods and drink that we consume, can that affect us spiritually? It definitely affects us physically, but can it affect us spiritually as well? Allah says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Addressing not only believers, but addressing humanity at large. He says, يا بني آدم, O children of Adam, as you adorn your external selves when you go to certain places, خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد, you adorn yourselves when you go to certain places of ritual and worship. Likewise, look at your internal states. كلوا واشربوا ولا تسرفوا. Drink, eat and drink, and do not be excessive. Eat and drink and do not be excessive. Why? إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. For verily He, Allah, does not love those who are excessive. We get blocked from potential divine love when we are excessive. And on what level? On a level of daily need, we have to eat. We have to drink. But on a level of daily need, when we are excessive, we may potentially be deprived of divine love. إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. There's a famous hadith we all quote from time to time, and we speak about the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam recommending a third for food, and a third for drink, and a third for your breath, air. Is it not? Na'am. But some people quote it as if it's a minimum, or as if it's a mere suggestion. And generally we do not quote the entire hadith. You know what the hadith starts with? The hadith starts with him sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, "Ma mala abnu adama wi'aan sharran min batni." The children of Adam, the son of Adam, does not fill a vessel, a container, worse than his belly. You fill your pockets, that's one thing. You fill your home, that's something else. You fill your bank account, alhamdulillah. But the worst that you can fill, were you even more accountable in relation to, is the belly. مَا مَلَا أَبْنُ آدَمَ وِعَاءً شَرَّ مِنْ بَطْنِهِ. The son of Adam has not filled a container, a vessel worse than his belly. بِحَسْبِ بْنِ آدَمَ أُكُلَاتٌ أَوْ لُقَيْمَاتٌ يُقِمْنَ صُلْبَ. Sufficient for the son of Adam is a few morsels with which he straightens his back. Enough to live, enough to be productive, enough to move sufficiently. Eat to live, not live to eat. The body has not been designed to take that amount. And Allah does not love on musrifeen. November is what? November is apparently decided by I don't know who, but it's good as a reminder. Diabetes Awareness Month. So simple fact, I am no doctor as you know, I am no dietitian as you know, but we need to educate ourselves. And it should not be only for those who see some gray hairs that they become more aware of their health. It should be for all, from young. And what the young are consuming today, having free access to, will affect them, will affect us. And they are not the leaders of tomorrow, they are the leaders of today. So, why Diabetes Awareness Month? Because there's an increase of people being diagnosed with diabetes too. And there are more children being born with diabetes too. So you know what's my obvious first question? What is diabetes 1? It's my obvious question. And with some consultation and with some research, I came to discover that diabetes 1 is when your immune system destroys the cells in the pancreas that produces insulin. Your immune system, your own body, destroys the cells that produces insulin. And insulin is important to transfer the glucose from your bloodstream to your muscles. Otherwise, it's a buildup of glucose. That's why people need what? Insulin injections. Right? Wait till brother up there, please. You need to stay with us. You need some sugar. Where are we? There's diabetes 1. Your own body destroys the cells that produces the insulin. So we know what's diabetes 2? Diabetes 2 is when your body is overworked. Is when your pancreas is so fatigued. It is too tired. It cannot produce the cells anymore by itself. And even if it were to produce cells, the cells are so weak, they die by them. They die out without any other intervention. It means some parents over-engaged to the extent that their children were born with pancreases that were too weak to produce the required cells. That is all that on a physical level. But on a spiritual level, if I know me being excessive is going to what? Deprive me of divine love. I should control my what? My desire. On a spiritual level, Rasulullah then ends the hadith. He says the worst vessel that a human being, that the son of Adam can fill is his belly. Sufficient is a few morsels that he what? That he straightens his back with. Then he says something unique, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says, فَإِنْ كَانَ لَا مَحَالَةَ. If there's absolutely no way out, and he has to engage in the food, has to have more, فَثُلُثٌ لِطَعَامِهِ وَثُلُثٌ لِشَرَابِهِ وَثُلُثٌ لِنَفَسِهِ. If there's no way out and he has to consume more, then a third for his food, a third for his drink, a third for his breath. So scholars of hadith have tried to understand and understand this hadith and see then when would one be in a situation where he has no excuse but to eat more. So the only time, you know, that they came to understand where someone would be obliged to eat more is when you are a guest at someone else's home and you want to honor your host by eating some more of what the host has made effort to prepare for you. Then you go to where? You go to at least a third for food, third for drink, and a third for breath. And some people have discussed, how do we ascertain a third and not a third and a quarter, etc. There are so many ways now, people who do gymming and do weight training, they look at exactly how many calories they take in for the day. How much carbs, how many carbs, how much protein, how many natural fats, etc. They can work it out. Work it out. Let's educate ourselves. Let's empower ourselves. Why? Because if we overindulge on a spiritual level, besides our bodies becoming fatigued, and may Allah protect us all, but we end up with illnesses and ailments that are not supposed to be. Food is supposed to be nourishing. Food is supposed to be that which gives us strength to do more and make better use of this gift of life. But now foods we consume are tying us down. Foods we consume are making us ill. Foods we consume are holding us back. So the excess is a no-no. For a believer even more, because إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. He, Allah, indeed does not love those who are excessive. Excessive in their preparation and excessive in their consumption. That's number one, the quantity. And then number two, the quality. Allah says, جَلَّ جَلَالُهُ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ. Again, the call is general. Oh mankind, كُلُوا مِمَّا فِي الْأَرْضِ حَلَالًا طَيِّبًا. Eat from all that is in the earth, that which is lawful and that which is طَيِّب. That which is halal and that which is good. طَيِّب is good. طَيِّب is pure. طَيِّب is nourishing. Al-Imam Ibn Kathir, one of the grand historians and mufassirun of the 8th century, said طَيِّب here in this ayah means that those entities, those food types and drink types that are pure within themselves and that are not harmful to the body and neither to the mind. What does that mean? It means that even back then, 7 centuries ago, they acknowledge that there are food types that may be halal, but for me, at a particular point in my life, it may not be good for me. It may be harmful to my body and my mind. He acknowledged that. And therefore Allah does not simply say, oh mankind, consume that which is halal. Allah says, consume that which is halal and tayyib. But look at the rest of the ayah. And this hit me. Allah then says, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. And do not follow the footsteps of shaytan. What, ya Rabbi? إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ. Verily he, in relation to you all, is a clear enemy. What does that mean, ya Rabbi? It means, to a certain extent, he, shaytan, has given up attacking us where our belief is concerned. Because we attack each other, we believe is concerned anyway. He's given up where our rituals are concerned, because people still do the rituals. So he looks for other avenues to address us, other avenues to pull us down, other avenues to affect us. And he said, لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ, I will surely come to them, مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ, from in front of them, وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ, from behind them, from their right sides, عَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ, وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ, and on the left sides. All sides, try. Allah says here, eat from that which is halal and tayyib, and do not follow the footsteps of shaitan. Meaning, he has some hand there, some influence there, some waswasa there in relation to what we choose or what is available for consumption. And what are the dangers, sir? We know the danger of consuming haram. We know that. Okay? But look at this. Tayyib and its spiritual consequence. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu anhu came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Udu'u Allah an yaja'alani mustajab al-da'wah. Pray to Allah that He makes me mustajab, like we say in Cape Town. Pray to Allah that He makes me one whose calls and pleas to Him are readily accepted. And He's a companion. And he accepted the message no matter what. He was on another level of faith, but he goes to Rasulullah and says this, and he has access to him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whose du'as are mustajab. The Nabi Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, does not raise his hands at this point and make du'a for him. Rather, he gives him one piece of advice. And that piece of advice was for us to, or is for us via him. What does he say? He said, if you want your du'as to be accepted, and we as a community, whether as a local community, national community, global community, we're faced with so many things on different levels of different kinds and different natures. And we raise our hands and we come together and we make dua. But we should do all that we can, all that we can, to make this vessel of ours ready and eligible for divine acceptance, this physical vessel. We know haram is a no-no. But what else, ya Rabbi, to make our duas for our for ourselves, make our du'as for our families, make our du'as for our community, make our du'as for the global community, make it more readily acceptable. What else, ya Rabb? Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam addressed Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu anhu and said, Ya Sa'd, atib mat'amak takun mustajab al-da'wa. See to it that your food is tayyib, not simply halal. See to it that your food is pure and good. You will most certainly become mustajab. You will most certainly become mustajab al-da'wa. Atib mat'amak takun mustajab al-da'wa. It is something that all the messengers of before were instructed with. Ya ayyuha rusul kulu min at-tayyibat. Eat from that which is pure and good. Wa'amalu saliha. And then you engage in actions and activities that are good and wholesome. In that same section in Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah addresses man and says, eat from the earth which is halal and tayyib, and do not follow the footsteps of shaitan. Three verses thereafter, Allah addresses the believers and says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, O those who have iman. In kuntum iyyahu ta'budun, if you are those who only worship Allah, then what? Kulu min tayyibati ma razaqnakum. Watch what you choose. Learn about your options. Learn about your choices and choose more wisely and consume from only the tayyib of that which we have sustained you with. And then, washkuru lillah, show gratitude to Allah. May Allah grant us understanding. May Allah grant us steadfastness. All those who are tested with illnesses, may Allah grant them patience and speedy recoveries. And those who are in charge of their affairs, may they be guided to what is best for them. But at the end of the day, whilst we are still here, even though our bodies have become conditioned to certain foods and certain drinks, whilst I am here, even a small change is significant. Even a small change will make a difference. At the journeys of a thousand miles starts with the first step, as they say. Every bit counts. Starts with my niyyah, for Allah's sake, to be more deserving of His love. I will not be as excessive as I may have been before, number one. And then number two, to be of those who are worthy of that direct line to Allah, open line to Allah, and more, and praise that are more readily acceptable. I will also make wiser choices in relation to this body that I have been blessed with. Inna li jasadika alayka haqqa. For Allah's sake, I will do this. I will not go into, Sheikh, your minds are maybe going into specific food items that we in Cape Town in particular have become accustomed to, and we can go into those. Like, say, I don't say cut out all the kusistas haji on Saturday, I'm just saying eat one less or eat a half, and every bit counts. Every bit counts, and Allah knows best. Wallahu subhanahu wa ta'ala a'lam. For His sake, Jalla Jalaluhu, I thank you for this opportunity. I pray that the community and the committee and the imama all are united even more in Allah's and Allah's protection, and taken from strength to strength. And I pray Allah makes us all deserving of His favor in this world and the next. Ameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallim wa barik ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Takbir. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Shukran, jazakallah khair, and baya terima kasih Fadilata Sheikh Ismail Lund for a very powerful message indeed, speaking to us on a very important topic of dietary choices have spiritual effects. And this message is in conjunction with International Diabetes Awareness. May Almighty Allah grant us the hidayah and the understanding to make wise choices with regard to our dietary choices. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. The Honorable Sheikh Ismail also authored a book recently called The Kaaba, Its Past and Future. And the book is available at the back in the gift shop, inshallah. Sheikh is currently the Imam at Masjid Al-Awwal, the Awwal Masjid in the Bukab in Dorp Street. And he is standing firmly, mashallah, in the footsteps on the mimbar and the mihrab of our honorable predecessor, Tuan Guru Rahmatullah Alayhi. May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to bless your Sheikh. Sheikh is also running very successfully the Dar Ubay Hafiz Institute, producing hundreds of Hufaz and memorizers of the Quran, following also in the footsteps of the great Sheikh Salih, Muhammad Salih Abadi, Rahmatullah Alayhi. May Allah bless you, Sheikh, and may Allah crown all your efforts with resounding success. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. I have a few announcements, but the main announcement I will keep for last. So first and foremost, we have been asked by our sister Halima from the UK. She requested us to make dua for 20-year-old Hannah Hussein. And this family every week witness and view our Jummah live on YouTube from the UK. And they request dua for Hannah Hussein, who suffers from a very rare form of stage 4 cancer. And the surgical procedure that she's about to go through is extremely intense. The family asks her to make dua that Allah bless her and Allah make her operation successful, and Allah grant Shifa and Kamila to all the sick people at home and in hospital. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. And then, as you know, Wednesday was the last day of the inquest into the death, or rather the brutal murder, of our great Imam al-Shaheed, Imam Abdullah Harun. Alhamdulillah, I managed to attend the inquest, and currently the judge will soon, inshallah, deliver the verdict. But a lot of lies were exposed. The evil that the apartheid government committed against our communities who were not of the European race. Wallahi, it is detestable. They claim that Imam Abdullah Harun fell down from the steps and he died. But we know in that year of 1969 in September, when they brutally murdered Imam Abdullah Harun for standing up for justice, standing up as a warrior to fight against evil apartheid. That night when they buried him, the Western Cape experienced a tremor, a shaking, a convulsion like never before. A tremor which extended right into Tulbagh, Ceres, Worcester, and all those outlying areas. And those of us, I was 9 years old that time in Standard One, but I could still remember that night of fear. What it was that you couldn't hold or grip anything because the entire earth under you was shaking. Imam Abdullah Harun is our Imam, our martyr, our father. Let us pray that Allah grant him Jannatul Firdaus. And this inquest brings about closure and relief to the family that suffered for years. His wife, Aunty Halima, rahmatullah alayha, whom I visited just prior to her death, passed away very sad that no justice was forthcoming for her husband, but also realizing that her husband passed away a shaheed. Today, we feel sad at the state that South Africa finds itself because of the sacrifices of Imam Abdullah Harun, of Steve Biko, and all the people who sacrificed their lives against the evil of apartheid. We know we were school children and were thrown into prison, shocked the daylights out of us, baton charged, whooped. We know, therefore, we are sad today what our people allow South Africa to have become, gone to the dogs. But it's not too late yet. We can still rise up. A luta continua, saying that the struggle continues and we continue to fight and stand for justice, equality, mutual love of all beautiful South African citizens, irrespective of the origin of your ethnicity or your race. We are a beautiful rainbow nation. Let us make a success of our country, South Africa. Amen. Also, we are on behalf of the Board of Trust and the Executive and the Imamat of Masjid al-Quds and the community, we make shukr to Almighty Allah and we thank Allah that our little young daughter, Abira Dekta, has been returned to her family safe. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heal her and her family from all trauma that they have experienced. And may Allah safeguard all our families in these evil days that we are witnessing. Amen. One of our executive members, Farooq Kotwala, and his family and many people in the community will be leaving for Umrah soon. Farooq Kotwala is leaving on Wednesday. We pray to Almighty Allah to grant you all a safe and salama travel, a Umrah Makbula, accept all your du'as and bring you back safely to your family and your friends. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And now definitely last but not least, before I make this announcement, allow me to say, and forgive me for my mispronunciations probably, Igameni lika ala ono Musa onesihau. Woti yena u Allah munye. U Allah o zimeleyo. Akazali futi akazalwanga. Futi ageko ufana naye. Sadaqallahu al-Azim. I can see you looking very confused. I have merely attempted to read Surah Qul Huwallahu Ahad in the Zulu language. Because the Zulu culture is very close to Islam. The Zulus also called Almighty God, they called him Umvelingange, meaning he is the one without beginning and without end, and that is Allah. That's why I say, Akazali futi akazalwanga, that Allah begets not nor is he begotten. And saying these words in Zulu, it gives me great pleasure and great honor to welcome to the Jummah today a princess, Her Royal Highness, Princess Mukilile Sibosiso Zulu. She is the sister of the current Zulu King of the Zulu Nation of South Africa and the daughter of the late Zulu King. She is here in Cape Town and she has decided to come and witness the Jummah here today. She is sitting with the ladies upstairs, and allow me to say to you, Your Royal Highness Princess Sawubona, welcome. We are indeed honored to have you here. And the Honorable Princess and Chief Mandla Mandela will both be the guest of honor of the Al Noor Educational Center here in Gatesville, who will be having the annual Jalsa tomorrow at the Darul Islam High School Hall in Cravenby. And we want to wish the Al Noor Educational Center all the success, because they are doing wonderful work in our community. And they are also doing great dawah work in the African communities, where many children are becoming Hafiz, learning Arabic, learning Islam, learning Dini studies. They are doing excellent work. To the Al Noor Islamic Educational Center, we say, may Allah crown you with success. And to the Honorable Princess Mukelile Sibusiso Zulu, and I don't know if Mandla Mandela is also present here, but we say welcome. Remember, this masjid is the house of Umvelingange, like every church, every mosque, every temple, every synagogue is the house of God. And when you enter the house of God, you must feel free, you must feel safe, and you must feel secure. May Allah Almighty, Umvelingange, bless you, Honorable Princess, and your entourage that are here, and may you derive maximum spiritual blessings from our Friday prayer, which is called Jummah. May Almighty Allah bless the entire South Africa and the entire world. Amen. Takbir. Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. All praise and glory is to Umvelingange, to Allah Almighty, the creator of the heavens and the earth. Shukran.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين رب اختم لنا بخير برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين والحمد لله رب العالمين
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين القوي المتين الذي لم يتخذ صاحبة ولا بنين أشهد أن لا إله إلا هو الملك الحق المبين وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله الصادق الوعد الأمين صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله على مر الدهور وكر السنين، ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن أزواجه وأصحابه وعن التابعين وتابع التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فيا إخوة الإيمان والإسلام، أوصيكم ونفسي أولا بتقوى الله فقد فاز المتقون، وأحثكم ونفسي على طاعة الله وطاعة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم، فمن يطع الله والرسول فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. ثم أذكركم وإياي أن أفضل الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، فنكتفي بقول الله تعالى وقول حبيبه عليه الصلاة والتسليم، فيقول الله عز من قائل في كتابه العزيز وفرقانه المجيد بعد قولي أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا بني آدم خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد وكلوا واشربوا ولا تسرفوا إنه لا يحب المسرفين. صدق الله العلي العظيم. وقال حبيبنا المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم: ما ملأ ابن آدم وعاء شرا من بطنه بحسب ابن آدم لقيمات أو أكلات يقمن صلبه، فإن كان لا محالة فثلث لطعامه وثلث لشرابه وثلث لنفسه، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم. بارك الله لي ولكم بالقرآن العظيم، ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم، إنه تعالى وهاب كريم، ملك بر رؤوف رحيم.
اللهم صل وسلم وزد وتوانم وتفضل وبارك بجلالك وكمالك على زين عبادك واشرف عبادك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وصحبه وسلم. سلم ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن كل صحابة.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدًا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله، أرسله الله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة. من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى، ومن يعص الله ورسوله فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا. أما بعد، فيا أيها المباركون اتقوا الله، واعلموا أن الله تعالى يقول في كتاب العزيز وفرقانه المجيد بعد قولي أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك، وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات، وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الأربعة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وعن بقية الصحابة والقرابة والتابعين وتابع التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعلي بفضلك كلمة الحق والعدل والدين، واجعل هذا البلد آمناً مطمئناً وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم اهدنا وسددنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا، ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى، وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي، يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم، وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة، الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله،
محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. استووا اعتدلوا. الله أكبر، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. يا بني آدم خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد وكلوا واشربوا ولا تسرفوا إنه لا يحب المسرفين. قل من حرم زينة الله التي أخرج لعباده والطيبات من الرزق، قل هي للذين آمنوا في الحياة الدنيا خالصة يوم القيامة، كذلك نفصل الآيات لقوم يعلمون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد، ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله، استغفر الله، استغفر الله. اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام، تباركت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، سمعنا وأطعنا، غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك والعظيم سلطانك، سبحانك لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم، ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم انصر المظلومين في كل مكان، اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا ويسر لنا أمورنا واختم بالصالحات أعمالنا يا كريم. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا واغفر لنا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم، وارزقنا جميعا حسن الخاتمة يا كريم. قال الله تعالى مخبرا وآمرا: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. اللهم افتح لنا بالخير واختم لنا بالخير، واجعل عواقب أمورنا في الخير، بيدك الخير والعافية إنك على كل شيء قدير. بفضلك دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم، وتحيتهم فيها سلام، وآخر دعواهم الحمد لله رب العالمين.
As temperatures drop and winter grips the country, the less fortunate in South Africa are preparing for the harsh realities that this season brings. Africa Muslims agencies on the ground distributing blankets, clothing and other essentials to thousands across the country. Sponsor a winter warmth pack for 280 rand to provide blankets, winter clothing and candles to families in need. Donate via Africa Muslims Agency and help us to spread warmth this winter. Africa Muslims Agency, commemorating 35 years of empowering, educating, inspiring.